Hi guys, so this is part two of the Gimp rings. And before this, we put tape on each side, and then we put glue or top coat on the top. Well, when that was dried, I took off the tape, I flipped it over, and then did the exact same thing. And now that side's dry too. So now what we're gonna do, stick the finger we want the ring to be in. And then just wrap it around again. And since we know this time that they will overlap, if they do overlap, it's fine. And you want to make it like good enough so then you can pull it in and out. So you don't want it to be too tight or too loose. Alright. So, I'm thinking I'm just gonna pull it out a bit. Alright. And if you're unsure, you can always measure it again because it's not like your finger's gonna get cut off. Alright. Okay, so this is it. And what you wanna do is take the glue or top coat. I'm gonna be using my top coat. What we're gonna do is bring this part flat down. So then, color. Then I'm gonna take your glue or your top coat and then just make it stick. My top coat is running out, so I need to get a new one. Now, as you can see, it's like still sticking up. So you can use your nails to push it down, or your actual thumb. Just press it down for a few seconds and then let it go. Let it go. Alright. Hold on to it. Alright, and now you just want to do the exact same on the bottom. Make sure it's lined up and it's not out like that. The song is called Call Me Maybe by Carly Rae Jepsen. If you can't adjust the side, like it's stuck there, take a pair of scissors and just cut it. And now you don't want it laying flat down because it might stick to the table. So you want to take another piece of scotch tape. And then you know how people like roll it up? You just want to roll it up. Alright. Now you want to put this part on the top. Place this on the bottom of it. Like so. Then just place it down on the table like that. Now all you have to do is wait for it to dry. And they'll show you how to decorate it. In part 3. So thanks for watching and I'll see you next time. Bye.